It was a team that was working in 5 cases: Argentina, Uruguay, Ecuador, Colombia, and Venezuela. Our interest was try to work in all South America, but the limitation of the grants don't allow us to finish the work yet, because we are trying to continue with this work. Well, our conclusion, we began understanding that leadership was not a subject very well studied in the social sciences. And our conclusion was that the emergence of different types of leadership is embedded in a context in when political parties, history, economic crisis, etc. perform and allow that the leaders can have more or less autonomy. And this autonomy is what made the strong leaderships going in a way far from the principles of democracy. The weaker institution, procedures, rules, all is permitted to increase their personal power. And because they are not strong political parties that can, in a way, balance this power, the situation is that these leaders create stability, but at the same time, they weak the democracy. And the only case in our 5 cases that is different is Uruguay. Uh-huh. In Uruguay, the political parties are really strong. There are habits to work with the opposition, to work with the Congress. The political parties have power to control the leaders. They have mechanisms to select the leaders. They put rules over the leaders. And this is a very different situation where you really find that including a new party, as is the Frente Amplio, the democracy became stronger. Yes, the political parties also became weaker, and leaders have more power to decide by themselves with a small team, changing their teams in a very personal decision making, and you don't see this interplay between institutions, political parties, Congress, etc. Well, difficult question. The reality is that one time that you have a strong political leader that arrived to power, they began to build and to organize a system to weak the institutions, to take power from the institutions, to take power from the Congress. In the moment that this leader became weak or have a lot of problems, economical, social, etc., it will appear another leader with the same condition that the probably schools, the speech that they give to become president or a senator is to make all the contrary of the predecessor, but when he's in power, he uses the same tool to gain power by himself. The third question related to our research is that political parties are a fundamental piece of democracy. It's to work for political parties, to have less but stronger political parties, and in the academic side, really try to inform the people that political parties are really important for the works of democracy. But at the same time, is the capacity of control that the society can develop. And we, in general, see in a lot of cases in Latin America that the people is able to put a president or another a governor or another political person out of his work, but they have no tool to control every day what the politicians do. The society must develop tools to have not control when the crisis arrives, but everyday tools for controlling the leader.